Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Michael Benjaminuddin from class IM 2463A. Today I would like to present to you my business model canvas for my company, which is hypersocks.co. Let's start with business background for my company. Hypersocks.co was established in December 2019. It is to aim to become an iconic cornerstone of downtown of Kuala Lumpur, designed with love by in-house artist Hypersocks.co, with together top quality designs and material tailored to fit current trend. Next is our problem statement for our business, which are expensive price and product emphasizing. First, we would like to go through expensive price, which most of the top product that were created or designed locally in Malaysia or other countries would be ranged from RM30 up to RM50, not including the shipping fee. For cheap material sock, this leads to a common issue for most of the customers, as they are requesting for a lower cost or comfortable and affordable pair of socks. Next is product emphasizing. Most of the local stock brands nowadays has produced a variety of type and material used in their product for businesses. In spite of the fact that it could be a good thing for the brand, it is not the same for the customer, as a brand will be more focusing on creating variety of product line and sooner will decrease the focus on the sock quality itself. This will lead to a lack of quality race among the competitor. Next, we go for a SWOT analysis for our two competitors for our business, which are Socks World and Progress Socks.
Socks World, in terms of strength, they are very well known brand and great at advertising. In terms of weaknesses, they are facing decrease in advertised product. In terms of opportunity, they have growth of the product market. In threat, they are facing new brand in the market. In Progress Socks, in terms of strength, they are very well known brand and a versatile product. In terms of weakness, they cannot focus on one product at one time. In terms of opportunity, there are experimental sales based on product. In terms of threat, vision of the business itself. For my business, hypersocks.co, our strength is our pricing and great advertising. And our weakness is low capital for advertising. For opportunity, we have a good brand image. And for threats, we are overflowing of competitors. Moving on to the opportunity recognition of my brand. Even my brand is not as big as the other two, but because of the power of social media and online marketplace that allows me to promote my product, because in order to survive in this business as a student, I have to use every opportunity that I have to the fullest to compete with the two brands that have been staple in Malaysian minds for a long time. For the purpose of business model canvas, in order to have a good flow in business, hypersocks.co has created a business model canvas that will help improving the workflow of the business and help identifying key elements in the business, such as customer segment, channel, customer relationships, revenue stream, key activities, key resources, key partnerships, and cost structure. By digging into these elements of the company, hypersocks.co can recognize and act on areas that can be improved. It also shows clear path for building the organizational innovation strategy. Next, we will go to our business proposal of my brand, hypersocks.co. We have 9 key elements to the business proposal. First is our customer segments. Our targeted audience are physical customer and online customer. Next is value proposition. We are focusing on pricing of the product. Next, channels. We are using social media to promote our brand. The flow of our supply will be from manufacturer, supplier, and next to the customer. Next, customer relationship. We are using the platform Facebook in order to communicate with our customer. Next is revenue streams. Revenues are gained from the customers. We are using fixed pricings in order to avoid profit loss. Next, key activities. We are using indirect channel so that the supply comes from manufacturer to the supplier and lastly to us. Next, key resources. The supplier are based in Johor so that the wholesaler are accessible to us. Next, key partnership. We are partnering with JNT Express, Post Laju and Facebook. Last but not least is the cost structure. We are paying for the shipping, advertisement and also the workers. Finally, we have come to our conclusion. As a conclusion, the aim for this brand is clear, that it is to supply the customers with good quality socks at a lower price. But in order to pursue the needs of the consumers, more experimental selling must be made. The following step for this brand to advance into a better trade is to sell the same product but with a diverse change, such as more variety of socks and packaging for the sock. The capital received will also be utilized to set up a workspace and hiring staff in order to smoother the process of ordering, distributing and idea collections. And that is the end of our presentation today. Thank you.